Z-axis extends the capability of current location-based services. It pinpoints the exact coordinates of responders, not just their vehicles, even in multi-story buildings. Z-axis for FirstNet provides a vertical reference point in terms of height above terrain, or HAT, to indicate the relative altitude or vertical location of the first responder. The following demonstration of Z-axis for FirstNet was recorded live in downtown Chicago using the widely available Response for FirstNet application on mobile devices and desktop displays.
So this screen depicts what the dispatcher could see within the comm center, what the incident commander could see, or the EOC could see, or frankly, anybody who has a web version could be on a tablet even. And there's Jonathan again. Thanks, Jonathan. That'll improve that experience for us. To the right of your screen, you're going to see a screen share of the mobile app, and you'll see Jonathan there. So you'll be able to see what will be seen in the mobile environment as well as in the web environment. And quickly, you're seeing his identification, both his name and his unit identifier, all customizable. You'll see the real date and time, which is constantly changing. You'll see his X and Y coordinates, and then you'll see the Z axis height above terrain. And remember, that height above terrain denotes meters or feet and is accompanied by that color coding, which indicates a confidence level of the accuracy of the reading. So as Jonathan heads up the stairs, what does this mean to you as a first responder? Well, we're excited that this first generation capability of Z-axis exists for public safety today. So imagine now with responders using the app on their mobile devices, for example, as an officer pursuing a suspect, and then that dispatcher, incident commander, EOC, or other personnel within a department could be logged into the web app or the mobile app and tracking the location of key personnel in real time. And with an awareness of responders now in that vertical location accuracy that we simply haven't seen and hasn't existed before. So Jonathan, I'm going to jump back to you now. As a retired deputy chief, operationally, what are your thoughts as you climb the stairs? We're seeing you in real time at 18 feet and on the second floor of the building you're in.
Well, my first thought is I need to start doing some more exercising. My second thought is that for me as a first responder, this would have been an extremely valuable officer safety tool. Many times you might be in a building. Chicago has many high rises, and I worked in public housing complexes that were 25 stories high, and you may not remember if you're on a foot chase or you're racing to the scene of an emergency, you may not remember what floor you're on if you have to take the stairs. So I'm walking up now to the third floor.
And so now at the third floor, he shows at 25 feet height above terrain, which, he's in a building with about 12 feet height per floor. So that's a reasonable estimation. Remember, there's also a plus or minus 3 meters at that green circle confidence level. But really, we think that, understanding that this is a first evolution of the technology, it's providing information with some context that public safety simply hasn't had before real time in the field. And now we see Jonathan at the fourth floor jumping to 42 feet. How are you doing?
I'm still breathing. I'm walking up to the fifth floor. You may recognize the stairway from the scenario. I think this is the same place that we take the scenario.
Right. And so now fifth floor. And he's still headed up, and you're seeing now it's jumped about 5 feet. And as he continues to go, you see per landing is probably 5 or 6 steps. He's making that jump accordingly.
Location services are going beyond what has been offered by GPS. Because the focus is on the responder, whose safety is most critical, this technology will transform public safety operations. For public safety, situational awareness is everything. More information about the surrounding environment helps first responders make better decisions to keep personnel and the public safe.